Racing in Europe can be a real eye-opening experience. Here's what some young American drivers have discovered.
Racing in Europe was not just, you know, a spur-of-the-moment idea. It was a result of many years of go-karting in Europe. So racing Formula cars in Europe, again, was a result of my familiarity with the European culture. Yeah, I mean, you can hop on an airplane and go over there, but it's going to be really difficult in terms of, you have to just understand how the people operate. I mean, in the end, they're just people, like, you know, you and I here in the U.S., but the way they eat, what times they eat, what languages they speak, how they relate to one another is quite different. And you have to go experience it to really see how that is. And to communicate, as long as you know English, it's quite okay, but if you make an effort to learn whatever country's language you're racing, if you make an effort to learn their language, they love that, and that's just going to make the transition to learn their culture seamless. In the end, I'm not perfect in Italian. I can understand it very well, and I can speak quite on a basic level, but I do use English in the end, with sometimes my engineer to make a clear point because I want to make a proper setup decision or whatever. But no, in the end, English is okay, for example, from the US, but you must try to learn their language, and they like that. Knowing the language will boost your confidence and also make them confident in you that you really want to do what you're doing, you know? Okay, in the U.S. there's cutthroat racing and karting as well, but even more so in Italy. Even karting and Formula car racing. For example, Formula 3 I was racing, you can close a driver to the grass. Okay, it's a bit dangerous, but they're quite more flexible. For example, in IndyCar, or I would assume in the Mazda Road to Indy series, you have to be quite more relaxed in terms of that. So you have to stay on your line, let's say, when somebody's approaching to pass you. Whereas in Europe, anything's open. So it is a bit more intense, but I mean, you will learn that because you're thrown with the wolves, you know? And if you don't act like them, if you don't push like crazy like them, you're gonna be eaten.
The battle for 15th or 16th was just as difficult, or if not more difficult, than the battle for the lead. And that's just how it is, you know, in Europe.
Yeah, in Europe, the driving is much more cutthroat. You know, there's just a different mentality. I think racing in America could be classified as a bit more fair, if you want to put it that way. Maybe that's a little bit biased, but certainly the edge of the sword is cut a lot more fine over there, and you definitely are put in a lot of riskier situations than over here. So that you definitely see some differences in mentality between the two sides of the pond.
Yeah, definitely. It's more like there's no rules over there. You know, you can pretty much do whatever you want. You can push people right off the track. You can run into people. I mean, like you said, it's pretty cutthroat. And it's just a different style of racing that, you know, the drivers from America are forced to get used to really quickly if they want to do well in the races. So you know, you just have to give it back, whatever they give you, and hope that, you know, you come out on top.
People don't wreck each other intentionally, or they don't try to, you know, crash you or anything because you're American. You know, a lot of those stereotypes, I guess I'll call them, are not true. But it's definitely, you know, everybody's racing each other as hard as they can, making like they're going for the win. And you know, it's just everybody wants to do as best they can.
Yeah, I mean, there's somewhat of a idea that, you know, they're a bit better than us because they're from Europe, they're from England, and this Americans, you know, they're not quite as good. But you know, we've showed that we go over there and we run really well. You know, we've won races, and so I think slowly but surely we're gaining respect from the Europeans. You know, they look at us as a threat now, you know, because we're coming over and we're running at the front and winning races. So
I think nowadays some Americans take a tough rap for not being the best drivers in the world, but I certainly don't think that's the case. I think the talent level here in America is just as good as it is in Europe. You know, I think possibly the depth of the fields is probably not as deep in Europe. But having said that, the guys that are up top are just as talented as the guys in Europe. And, you know, certainly there's a little different philosophy between the two different sides of the pond. But I think, you know, hopefully in the coming years with what's happening with the IZOD IndyCar series and everything that's developing, I think we're definitely earning a lot more credibility now, and I hope it continues to go in that direction.
Yeah, no, safe is fast. It's the way to go. It's obviously something that, you know, you have to use your mind to do it properly. And you can drive fast but safe, so definitely the way to go.